I don't follow Jesus in order to get into heaven after I die. I follow the way of Jesus because I want to experience a life of peace, joy, and love right here and now.
Okay, let me get this straight. So you follow Jesus to get his stuff. Well, here's the funny thing, though, is that Jesus doesn't actually promise us that we will feel love and peace and happiness all the time. In fact, he promised that if we seek to follow him, to live godly in Christ Jesus, that we will be persecuted. Now, that's not a popular message, but that's the truth. You know, the promise is that he will be with us in the midst of that suffering, in the midst of that trial. It's not that we will feel good and feel happy. That's a prosperity message that has no grounding in scripture. And unfortunately, it's leading a lot of people astray, because when they believe that is the gospel, if they're turning to Christ to get his stuff, to get those nice, warm, fuzzy feelings, what happens when they encounter depression? What happens when they encounter anxiety and trials and heartache and tragedy? They think that God has left them. It's not that he promised us that we would never encounter those difficult things. It's that he promised that he would be with us in the midst of them. The sick thing about a lot of people that preach the prosperity gospel is that they'll say that, oh, you're sick or you're encountering these trials because you're not believing enough. You're not trusting God enough. That's why you're experiencing these heartaches. Well, when my mom had breast cancer, when she was dealing with that, you know, if somebody were to walk up to her and say, oh, you're experiencing that because you don't have enough faith, because otherwise God would heal you, or you feel sad because, well, you're not tapping into what God has already given you, I would have punched that for a person in the face. It's like, you know, that's not true. That's not right. That's sick. And trying to blame people or accuse people of not being good enough Christians because you're not experiencing all these supposed things that are already available, it's just not right. And I know if you guys have experienced those trials in your own life, you know, okay, look, I'm still following Jesus, but I am feeling these really real things that are not fun, that are devastating. I need to be able to say that gospel that man is preaching, that is not the true gospel. The true gospel is that Christ has given us his grace and his love through the sacrifice of Jesus, that we would be made right with God. And that even though we'd still experience the difficulty of sin and a broken world, that he would be with us in it. And that, you know, he would never leave us or forsake us. And that is ultimately enough. This video is brought to you by my patrons on Patreon. It is because of your guys' support that I can continue to make this content. Ultimately, my goal is to go full-time, so head on over to my Patreon down below if you want to help me get to that goal and continue my mission of helping people follow Jesus daily. You can follow me on all sorts of different social media at It's Isaac David, and I will see you guys next time. God bless.